Right, driver's briefing. Okay.
Driver's briefing, let's go.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, everybody. Hope you can all hear me okay. Welcome to your driver's briefing for the third round of More Female Racers. Big F, Oscar. It's not the at symbol, it's the and symbol. And swap. Space. One. So, everybody, welcome again to the third race. Third round of this season of More Female Racers, and we're back at Imola. Going into the qualifying session shortly, I'd like to remind everybody that the session is session is split. So the first 10 minutes of this qualifying session, remember, are for those drivers who are competing in the AM and the Pro AM class. So those are the drivers who have the black background with white number, or those with the red background and the black number. That's those of you in Pro-Am and Am. First 10 minutes of the qualifying session is for you. And then once there's 10 minutes left on the session, all those in Silver and Pro may leave the pit lane. If you're in Silver and Pro, do not leave the pit lane when there is more than 10 minutes left on the session. And for those of you in Pro, Pro-Am and Am, don't continue to lap if there is under 10 minutes to go, unless you have started a new lap with more than 10 minutes on the session. If you're unsure if you crossed the line in time, then pull off the track safely and use return to garage. That being said, return to garage can be used in qualifying session. Just make sure you are stopping the car off the track safely away from everybody else so you don't impede anybody. And then you can use return to garage. One thing, final thing I do want to mention on the qualifying. At Spa, I noticed that there was, I think, just one the AM or Pro-AM cars who began a lap with just more than 10 minutes to go. 10 minutes and a few seconds to go. And then by the time they actually reached near the end of their lap, they got held up by drivers who were in the Silver and Pro class, who were going very slow on the outlap, that they actually were ended up holding this driver up as they came to complete their lap. So please bear in mind, those of you in Silver and Pro, use your co-driver to assist you, that if there is any Pro-Am or AM cars out on the track, you need to be aware of where they are. If all the Pro-Ams and all the AMs are back in the pit lane, then you don't have to really worry. But use your co-driver to pass you that information.
Same message every day.
Are there any Pro-Ams or AMs still on the track? And if so, where are they? So you can make sure you move out the way and you don't impede them. Once the qualifying is done, then we'll obviously go onto the grid for 5 minutes while you prepare the setup of your car. And then we go into the full formation lap of the circuit here at Imola. And then we will go green flag. 1 hour race as all the rounds are in the series this season.
Yeet it to the moon!
Remember that there is that 23-minute stint timer, and that it is to be the female driver doing the qualifying, the first stint of the race. That's the race start.
Both female drivers.
The first 20-odd minutes
of
the race.
I reckon I should do qualify.
Then the co-drivers to do the middle stint, and then the female drivers to take over.
I actually don't. I'm going to be slower than Sarah in this one.
Each pit stop, so the two mandatory pit stops that you have to carry out during the race, both of them do require tyre changes. Those are mandatory. So make sure you do change your tyres. This is so that those teams who are racing solo, they don't gain any advantage in the pit lane, as the tyre swap and the driver change takes the exact same amount of time.
I went on Ashtonir and then I...
It's been a while since
got
we
stuck
did
in a
race
cave,
here in Imola. Actually,
collected
I think the
all
last
the stuff.
Time we did race here, it was in the wet. But
after falling
I
down
do
that hole,
there was
I actually fell down another hole a bit later on.
In that race, and
but
we've
I
seen
to dig
so far
out
in the, the first couple of rounds of this season, we've also seen a fair few crashes. Crashes do happen; they are part of racing, especially in
Cheers,
a series
Dale.
Like this,
Thank
where
you.
We've got some drivers who are brand
I hope
new.
It's an entertaining race, but a good
sim racing, and I mean that is what this series is about, isn't it? Getting brand new female drivers into the world of sim racing. Or into the world of ACC if they're already doing sim racing. So accidents will happen, even at the best of times. You know, you look at some of the best drivers in the world in Formula One, they will still crash. If any of you watched the Formula One race yesterday, there was a crash at the first turn. So crashes will happen. One of the big things, though, we
I
do want to see
holes,
is how drivers react to those. And drivers' reaction times when it comes to things like yellow flags. So make sure you're paying big attention to things like yellow flags. They are warnings of danger ahead. Particularly if you're getting double yellows, this means it's an immediate danger. What we don't want to see, and unfortunately what is far,
is there actually any
far
difference
in
ACC
racing,
between
is
a
drivers
normal yellow
at
and
yellow
a double
flags
yellow.
And think, oh, there's
because I've never noticed
five cars over there that have crashed, so now I get to overtake five cars and get five places. However, by speeding through to try and overtake five cars, you actually then make it six cars that's crashed, and then seven and eight and so on and so on. So please use those flags to actually advise when they're advising you to slow down. Then if the situation is calling for you to slow down, then do that. Rather
Assess
than using it as an opportunity to go full throttle and try and overtake everybody.
And slow down
it's not
if needed.
Generally what they mean.
Be prepared to slow down if needed.
Other than that though, I think already in the first couple of races we have seen good improvement. Especially if we compare, say, the start of Spa to the start of Monza. Although one thing, again, that we did see at Spa was a bit further down the grid, if I remember correctly, was a bit of an incident from some of the newer drivers. But this ties into what I just said.
I mean, I got punted by a very experienced driver, but we'll gloss over.
Of course, the main thing is about trying to be predictable, especially if you are new, trying to avoid sort of sweeping from left and right on the circuit. You just want to... The safest way to have a race start is to try and get a single file as soon as possible. And obviously, do remember here at Imola, one of the big things at the start of the race, and one of the reasons that crashes are quite frequent here at Imola, is purely because of the curbs on the inside at turn one, and then again the inside on the right-hand side
at
turn two. Catch those curbs wrong, you will cause cars,
well,
particularly that curb
it.
On the inside at turn one. If you're pushing cars too much onto that curb, they will bounce up, and the way the contact physics work here in
but
ACC.
He basically tells you exactly
now
what's going to happen.
And take you out.
So
actually, if you're on the
that ends up being exactly what happens.
Of the track going into turn one, and you cut across too much, you are actually pushing P2 or whoever's alongside you
Which
to
I think
actually
is fine.
Crash you.
In
so
like a classroom
mind,
environment.
Try and
don't think
always
it's fine.
Leave as much
in
space
a driver's
as possible
briefing.
At the race start. Avoid touching those curbs as much as possible. Not good for your tyre pressures, and not good for avoiding.
Why is there
collisions.
A cat in here? Move.
So that's everything to go through. Qualifying is going to begin in just... Well, we'll forward the session in just a few seconds, really. So remember, first 10 minutes is for the AMs and Pro-AM cars only.
Okay.
Silvers and Pros, you can leave the pit lane when there is 10 minutes to go in the session.
10 minutes to
Thanks,
go.
Thanks, everybody. Good luck. Most importantly, have fun.
Yee.
Speak to you in a couple of weeks at round four.
Thank you. Bye. Let's get out of here. Always fun.
That was exciting.
Wasn't it just?
Yeah.
I like being told what not to do.
Yep.
Right before a situation in which that's exactly what's going to happen. How does
he
it compare
knows what's
with...
going to happen, that's why.
Well, yeah, but the more you talk about it, the more it's likely it's going to happen. How does it compare to, like, a real-life driver's briefing?
No, it's pretty much the same.
Is it really?
Yeah. Or just, like, track limits, watch track limits, track limits, track limits.
Okay.
Yeah. And flags. We just run a few flags for us.
Always the flags. We were just discussing in chat whether we've ever seen a double yellow in ACC.
No.
Doesn't happen.
No, it doesn't happen. I've never seen a double yellow.
Because it doesn't happen.
Plenty of yellows, though. Always.
Yeah, but I think you should especially watch out for the double yellows.
Double yellow, carnage ahead.
Yeah, if you see them, don't think you can overtake five cars.
Double yellows means carnage ahead, abort to the grass.
Yeah. Just eat it off at the first available opportunity. Oh, dear.
I think I'll just run my 24 litres for quality. Yeah, it'd be fine.
The wait and the anticipation.
This is the exciting bit, just waiting.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think they should let us all go. Fuck it.
I think they should. I don't see why not.
I'm sure in the first two seasons, I think they just let us go.
Yeah, they did. They did. But then they stopped because they were like, oh, it's carnage. I'm like, well, it's only going to be like this in a race. So, you know, we need to kind of practice being out on track with each other.
Exactly. Yep. Totally. Learn how to deal with the carnage or just avoid it entirely.
Exactly.
Everyone's in the Ferrari detox. Everyone. Look at all these. They're all in the Ferrari. We have no choice. I mean, I actually did get a choice. I had some say over which car it was. It was either the Ferrari or the Merc Evo. And I thought, I don't want
to
drive the Merc.
7 minutes to go.
So I voted for Ferrari.
Could get a little nap in.
Someone over the weekend that drives for us was actually sleeping in his rig when he was supposed to be driving. I'm not even kidding.
No way. Were you all, like, trying to wake him up over the voice chat?
I wasn't there, like, so I don't know exactly what happened. I just heard about it afterwards.
That's so funny. I did the 24 hours of Le Mans and iRacing, and, one of the guys actually, I'd done his stint, to be fair, but he fell asleep in his seat, but his stream was still running. So all people could see was him asleep in his rig.
Do you still do much iRacing?
No, not really. I'm not really a massive fan of it, to be honest.
Fair enough.
I do the odd bit just for fun. And I'll do, like, the fixed setup races.
Yeah.
But, you know, the races where you do your own setup, it's just way too complicated.
Yeah.
To get, like, a decent setup on iRacing. Crazy. And you have to spend a lot more time practicing to be fast.
Yeah, I'm not doing that.
Or a good pace, you know. So, yeah, so when I go on it, I just go on it with friends and we just mess around.
Cool.
Yeah. Since I switched to ACC, I've not really gone back to iRacing.
That's fair. I'm getting more into it, so I'm trying to do both.
Yeah, I think I will do a bit more on iRacing over winter, like with some of the endurance races, but...
Yeah. I quite like it. I like mid-engine cars. They're more difficult to drive, but it's good fun. It's no Nissan, that's for sure. Melissa up in second.
The track is still fast.
This is a joke.
This is ridiculous.
I think we all need to complain in Discord.
Yep.
Optimum or we riot.
Reset.
Reset, or we'll all be slipping inside, sliding into turn one.
I mean, that is, yeah, that is gonna happen.
I always forget how many people there is in our class. Wow.
Am I using your TC setting? I have no idea. I don't know what your TC setting is. Probably not. And I can't see us changing right now. Look at Taplin go. Yee. Just need to Louise to go a bit faster. Lisa, sorry. And then we've got 1-2 in Am? Are they Ams? Or Pro Ams? I think they're Ams. Oof. What happens when you do that then? Does it make it... Does it turn it into a rocket?
Oh yeah, it's gone to optimum. Woo!
Finally!
About time.
So you're in for the 41s, yeah?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Oh, we can leave the pits now, can't we?
Well, you can go to the end of the pits.
Let's go to the end.
You can't leave until it says 10.
I'll just get really slowly.
I'm sure that weaving is really helping.
Yep. That's just me really bored. Just getting that 0.1 PSI.
Okay, if we get
no
time...
No tire pressure, no shit.
We'll try it. But it's kind of like, it's a bit late to be trying stuff.
20 seconds.
And I only get a 20 minute stint, so... I don't want to be messing about with stuff I don't understand.
Two, one, go. Oh, you're also slow. Come on.
Okay. If you get a chance, I'd probably go ahead at this one.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Everybody messing about in qualifying. It's okay, got plenty of time. Nice. Great lap.
Not that much, Sarah.
Looking good, though.
Yeah. Now I just have to do it again.
So nervous watching qualifying in like a team event, especially when it matters. Like, I normally don't think qualifying matters, but it kind of does here, I think. Stuff. You can hit those 42s now.
We're getting there.
Yep. Awesome, awesome.
Oh, so close.
Nicely done though, well done. Well, it's fourth in class.
Nice. I'll do.
Yep, happy with that. Sophie's second overall.
Really?
Yep.
Oh my god.
142.0.
Sheesh.
She's so gonna get kicked out.
Of this class. She should totally be in the class above.
Yeah, I don't mean forever. just the class. Now that was a great lap actually. Well done. Hey, Ricardo. I do have some bad news, however. We've fallen back to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in class.
Really?
Yeah, just with the final
Damn.
Laps.
Oh. Just thought I'd yeet him. See you later.
Oh, God.
Totally wasn't concentrating.
Penalties incoming. I think we're ahead of most of, like, the championship people that we need to care about, though. So that's good.
Good. Oh my god, as if Taya's 6 overall. Oh my god. Don't know where my man is, to be honest. Can't see a thing.
Awesome. This is just the attitude I want to see in the race.
I don't actually know where he is. Yep, lost him.
Oh, good. Thanks, Ricardo. How are you? How are you doing?
It's like the world's longest pit lane.
You generally missed the person, didn't you?
Yep.
Cool.
I couldn't see him because, like, everyone was in the pits.
How dare they?
Right. Right, fuel. 50 liters. pit stop. We had 40. However many, I can't remember. For the pit stop.
It was 47, I think.
Was it 47?
We go 48.
Why not?
Go 48.
48. Use current pressures. And there's only one pit stop, so we're good. Right.
What do you mean there's only one?
Two.
There's two.
That's what I meant.
Okay, good.
13. Right, there we go. 48. We should be good. Whoa, how dare you do that? My electric just had a random surge in my house and I nearly shit myself for a moment then.
Brilliant.
Are we leaving it on break one or are we going for break two?
Go break one. It's a short race. Hey, Oswin, thank you for that.
Set the pit stops. Yeah. Yeah, I think we're good.
Cool beans.
From breaks too, actually.
I'll be back in 1 minute, just gonna get a drink.
No worries. Where is? Oh, cool. Right in the middle for the start. Oh, I would do.
We confident?
Yeah.
Excellent. That's exactly what I want to hear.
I'm just like I'm right in the middle.
Yeah, absolutely nothing can go wrong here.
No, I think we're in a perfect position.
Definitely. Right we've side got, of the track, right in the middle.
Perfect driver in front of us.
All good.
Yeah.
I'll be amazed if everyone makes it through T1 and 2.
Yeah, me too.
I really will be.
Never say never. It might happen one day.
You never know.
Can't believe Sophie put it P2.
I can.
That's crazy. She's like way too good for our class.
Yeah, I mean, like, 4 of the top 5 are GTWR.
Yeah.
5 of the top 6, actually. It's kind of insane.
Yeah. They should just have their own class.
Yeah. They can just all be pros.
Yep. Always good when you need a toilet before you start a race.
Oh my god.
30 seconds. It helps. it's like me in real life. I always need the toilet before I start a race, but it's fine because I just sweat it out and then I don't need the toilet when I finish.
That's amazing.
Feeling ready. Let's go.
Good stuff. Oh, it's weird. This is the strangest camera angle ever. Cheers, Ricardo. Chat is saying good luck.
Whoop, whoop. No pressure.
None
don't
whatsoever.
Mess this up.
I think just...
Don't be that person.
Yeah, don't be that.
Why? Just... Why are you ghosting each other? Come on, guys. Honestly. Drivers and then there's screwdrivers. Yeah, I just, like, last time I attempted a race here, I just braked too early into turn one because I get scared.
Okay.
I'll try not to do that, though.
I mean, it's better to brake earlier than later, I think.
It is, but then it depends how close the person behind you is.
Yeah. What we got? Schenker.
I don't know.
I think she's reasonably okay, to be honest. Yeah.
I think it's the two that are in front of me that I gotta be wary of. My tyres are a little bit green.
Ooh. What does that mean?
They're not, like, super cold.
I know.
Just green on the edges.
Okay. A bit of braking, maybe.
Yeah.
We will try. So yeah, main thing, first couple laps, just look after the car.
Do my best.
Yep. And just look at what's happening ahead if you can.
Yep. Love it when people do that.
Good luck. I thought that was the start finish line then. Fuck's sake. But it's not, it's up here. Wait. Okay, carnage behind. It's all good ahead. Cool. Nice start, well done. But it's good, it's all good. Good lap, really good lap.
Breathe now.
Yep. Settle down now, settle down.
Feel like just sitting and watching this unfold.
Yeah, yeah. Cars behind are fighting, so don't worry too much about them. Pace is good. I can see you catching Witcher. I think she'll make a few little mistakes here and there.
Yeah, I'll just keep the pressure on.
Yep.
Minimal mistakes.
Nice and consistent. This is good stuff. Dive. Wait. Okay, good. That was a massive fucking dive.
Just a bit.
Thought she was going to overshoot, to be honest.
I was like, I'm going to have to turn in. Like, if I don't turn in, I'm not going to make the corner. Thank you.
Nice. Let me know if pressures and everything is okay.
They're like 27.6. Do you want me to box this, that?
Can do. Entirely up to you.
See if... Who's in front, Celine, if she boxes?
I mean, I don't think it makes that much difference. But, yeah.
She's not.
Ah. Whoa, 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 whoa! Ah, oh, so close. Well done. That was a really good stint.
I had like two rubbish laps, but other than that, it was alright.
Yeah, it was good. It was good.
Yeah, the pressures were like up and down a little bit, but most of it they were okay.
Okay. Ignition on, yeah?
Pardon?
Ignition on.
Yeah. Oh. 15 seconds.
Okay.
10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go, go, go! Ooh, friend!
Hello! Fancy seeing you here.
Fancy seeing another car in the pit lane. Well, good luck. Have fun.
Cheers.
Nice lap. Good first lap.
Cheers. Felt good.
Yeah, looked good. Nice. The same pace as the two cars ahead, but the one behind you is faster. You've got a nice gap, so.
Okey-dokey.
Nice.
That felt good.
Yeah, that looked really good.
Eek.
Ah, you're good.
Oh man, they really do put me against aliens, don't they?
Yeah. It's on your right. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, he's like in like the 41s.
Fuck's sake. Hey Lewis. Cheers for popping over. Who's his teammate?
I don't know actually. Who's in 87? I don't know. Let me look.
It's Valencia or something.
Oh.
Cheers for the sub, man. Oh, thanks, man. Really appreciate that. I wish I could talk more, but I can't talk and drive at the same time.
Yeah, Laura? Valencia?
Ah, Lenska? Okay, whatever.
Valenza, that's one. Don't know. Yeah, it's one of the GTWR teams.
Well, they can fuck right off. Okay, so stint time is 25 minutes, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Nice save. Ah.
So I've got 6 minutes and 6.5 minutes left.
Cool.
Do you want me to go long or do you want to take over sooner?
Whatever you want. I'm cool.
Right, I hate this car now. Yeah, I think everyone will be going along.
There's some proper aliens out there.
I know, it's ridiculous.
That's crazy. The tie pressure's okay.
They're a little high, but they're not too bad.
Are they?
I think I'm just sliding it around a bit more.
Yeah. Getting aggressive with it.
I'm just trying to go fast.
I've been trying, like, all my practice sessions to be smoother.
Yeah, normally I like being smooth, but... it's just not happening with this carbon track. Okay, now. Right, I'll do one more lap and then I'll be in.
Cool.
Okay, box, box.
Cool.
Fucking hell, that's tough.
They were so fast.
Shit, yo, I missed the box, didn't I? It always fucking changes. It's in reverse as well. I've well and truly fucked it.
Well.
20 seconds.
Just remember to enter first.
Yep. 15. 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Let's go.
Go get them. Go and get back all those places that I lost.
I don't think we lost any, did we?
We lost one, I think.
Did we? Yeah.
I think so. I'm not entirely sure if it was outright position.
Well, we came in 10th. So.
Okay. Alright, nothing behind you.
Cool. I love it when I lose my mirror.
Oh yeah.
For sake. Oh well. I'll just leave it for now.
Terrible stop. It was a terrible stop. But what are you gonna do? Must do better next time. Yeah, yeah, we know. I don't think it really matters at the moment. We're not in danger of being overtaken by anyone. And I think the guys behind will be pitting, so... it's all good. Honestly, you get that 42.9.
A 42.9?
Yeah. If I could do it, you could do it.
No pressure then.
Nah, it's all good. I think you do that part a lot better than I do.
I've practiced that so many times because I used to get it so wrong. In the Lexus, I hated that corner.
Nice. Good lap. Should be able to set this one up for the main straight.
A toe somewhere.
You've got time if you want to leave it for another lap.
Ideal.
Yeah, definitely not perfect. Hey Nelson, how's it going? How are you today? Yeah, I think we'll get P10. Seemed to be a fair bit faster. It's just getting the moves done. Without dying at the same time. Thank you. Nice. You got this.
I nearly put my brake pedal through the floor then.
Just keep putting pressure on.
Later.
Wicked. It's a really difficult circuit, actually. As much as I like it, it's really tricky. This part is always tricky, in a car, in a mid-engine car especially. This chicane is always tricky, in any car. But also in a mid-engine car especially. Thank you. Oh man, no one ahead is getting the good penalties.
I don't really think she was concentrating.
Yeah, Charlotte's a bit erratic.
Bit of a random line she took.
It was very strange. I was like, you moving over, like, intentionally? Because it's a bit early. Two more laps. One more lap. No. One more lap. Looks like it's all kicked off here.
I know.
P10, nice one. Good stuff.
That was a hard race.
It was. I kind of expected it to be honest, but... It was good. No mistakes. Didn't hit anything that I can remember.
No, didn't hit anything or anyone.
No penalties.
No?
I mean, my pit stop was a bit of a shit show, and I'm sorry for that. But aside from that...
it's fine.
I don't actually think we lost out too much.
No, I don't think so. The aliens were really quick today.
Well, that's why the aliens, isn't it?
Yeah.
What is going on here?
What's going on?
It's a fucking GTWR.
Oh, let's get a picture. Do you know what? No, we don't want a picture, do we? No. Come on now.
Just come right
now.
In the middle of it.
Just gonna chill here. Cheers, guys.
Awesome. Alright, good stuff.
Yeah, I love this track, but it's always a hard race because it's so hard to overtake.
Yeah, I think it's a really tricky circuit for this car as well. It doesn't like it.
Yeah. So, like, I felt good in, like, sector one, sector two. It's just the final bit of the lap where that's where if I lose time, it's always, like, the chicane and the second to last corner.
Yep.
Always lose time there if I'm going to lose time.
You did well, though. Like, there was no sort of major... I don't know, yeah. If, like, you feel that you've improved since, like, the last couple of seasons.
Oh, massively.
But I can see it for sure. Definitely. Yep.
No, I definitely have. I don't make nowhere near as many mistakes as I used to. I've never been one for, like, taking people off. I don't think I've ever had that tagline.
Yeah.
But I just make mistakes. But I don't think I made any that time. I think I had just more bad laps than I made mistakes.
Yeah, yeah. There was nothing there that I thought. Ooh.
No.
GG.
I didn't get any invalid laps in the last stint.
Woo!
All right.
1, 2, 3. I got 3 in the first stint. Damn.
I think I got 1 or 2, and I got a track cut as well.
Oh, did you?
I think it was the second lap I was doing. It was, you know, Aquamini Rally, the two right-handers at the bottom of the hill.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It was the second part of that, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You went straight over it, didn't you?
No, it wasn't that time, actually. It was a different time.
Oh, was it? Really?
Yeah. It was on a really, really good lap. But, yeah.
I did a 43.008.
That's not bad at all.
Ah,
I think close. You can be happy with that. I mean, I would be.
Yeah. It's just like... one of those. That setup was safe, but I like the other setup would have been quicker, but I would have been more on the edge. So I was like, I'd rather just keep it on the track.
Yeah, exactly. I thought it was quite on the edge as it was, to be honest. I felt like I struggled a bit. Like I got a couple of quick laps in, but I'm not usually that inconsistent. I just made a couple of small mistakes here and there.
Yeah. I didn't find it like very loose on the rear. I just found it quite understeery. It was only loose on the rear if I hit a curb.
The answer is definitely
but other than that, it was... I just had a load of understeer, but that's probably me just being impatient.
Yeah, just slow down.
I don't have much patience. I'm like, get to a corner, get to the apex. I'm like, I want to go now. Let's hit the power. No, you don't want to go? You're going to understeer? Okay, nice.
It is actually very understeery on power.
Yeah.
It needs the patience.
Yeah. Just needs a bit more patience. Where's the next one? Ah, oh, Silverstone. They need to make that a wet race.
You think so?
Yeah. No one likes Silverstone, do they?
No one. Well, I... Yeah.
It's awful.
It's. I don't mind it. I don't think it's as bad as people say, but it's not up there with some of the tracks like this one.
No, it's definitely not up there with, like... My favourite tracks. I want to watch the start. Oh, whoa. That's not the start. I thought the start was quite good, actually.
The start was really good. You very nearly got hit by someone behind.
I did.
But because it didn't happen, I just didn't mention it.
I just had to turn in, look to my mirror, and I was like, oh, that was close. And then I just saw a crash behind. I was like, oh, it's fine. Carry on.
Yeah, exactly. And I didn't want to disturb you at that point.
Yeah, because Celine in front, she braked, then came off, then braked again. So it really confused me. Yay. I can be quite proud of making it through the first two corners.
Yeah, it was an absolute shit show behind you.
I know. I saw it all like start and I was like, oh my god, thank god, that's not me. Where did we end up? 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, 6th. That's right. Yeah, I think I'll need to put some laps in around Silverstone to find some time.
I'm just watching the replay of the start and I can't actually work out what happened. It was such a mess.
Yeah, I just watched it and I couldn't figure it out either, to be fair. Without going through like each individual car.
Yeah, I mean there's about four cars off just in that bit alone.
Yeah.
How do we get names up? There's a button you can... Ah, there we go. Did it not do it on all the other views? No. Oof. Okay. Who's this? Kuchkova.
Oh, Kamugli, basically went straight over to Mon.
No, it was before that she got hit.
Was it?
Yeah, she got hit by Kuchkova, car number 14. You just sent it straight into the back of it, I think. Actually, Kuchkova got hit by someone else.
I was going to say, I just missed it.
So she got hit by Bashenka. Actually, that's quite hard to judge. Because Bashenka did hit her on the side, but Kuchkova was going far too fast.
Yeah, and it was a pretty small gap. Like, you can just fit the car there.
Oh yeah, she shouldn't have been there at all.
Yeah, I'd probably say that's... I don't know, a couple of classes of racing incidents, 10-1. Oh. See, that was me, like, last series. I got taken out 10-1. And actually, I think I took... Actually, last season I did take someone out at Imola. Yeah. Big time.
Wait, there wasn't Imola last season, was there?
Or was it the season before?
It must have been before.
Could have been the season before. But I properly took someone out on, like, nice. the double right before the chicane.
It's good to know to do that, just know what it feels like, and then you learn not to do it again.
Yeah, those were the days when I couldn't get that corner right. Now I'm like, I've practiced it that many times that I'm all right.
How do we look backwards? Can't, can we?
I love watching Carnage back. I'm just laughing because it wasn't me.
Yeah.
I wonder what Marion got a penalty for, though. I don't see that.
Thank you.
Ah, nice.
I'm just watching the replay back of the last... Was it the last lap at the chicane?
Yep.
What a fucking mess that was!
Oh, yeah. was that what we kind of turned up and everything had already kicked off?
Yeah, I think it was Annalise Wyatt hitting Mel Taplin, who and then there were two or three cars that drove into it, basically. Can't really avoid it.
But them two were slightly in front of us.
Yeah.
Lisa literally was a dead stop at the middle of the chicane because Annalise was facing the wrong way.
Yep.
And then is it Sarah Fair? I don't know what her name is.
Yeah.
She literally, you can see the accident from like halfway round the first corner, and she decides to, in the middle of the corner, put the power on while we're trying to avoid the accident in front and rear ends us. Into the other car, what bounces off Mel's front, then bounces back into us, sends us into the wall.
It was an absolute mess by the look of it.
Yeah. I just came around and was like, oh, it's all kicked off here.
Yeah, because we were just like, you know, last lap, just going to finish the race, bring it home. And then all of a sudden, there's like four or five cars ahead going slowly. And we're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I got turned by another car, and the same sort of thing. Outbraked them into a corner. They tagged us on the rear. We went into the like half in the gravel trap, left tires, and as I was keeping it, trying to keep it on the track, they decided to just take their normal racing line and hit us off, which sent us into a wall. And then the same thing happened to Lisa on the first corner, pretty much. People taking their own racing lines, not really caring what's happening to the cars in front, and just rear-ending you.
Do you know who it was in both instances?
Car 2. So, whoever that is, C. Marsh, whoever that is.
Cosmo, okay.
Yeah. And who was the other one?
I just make sure that you get protests in.
Oh, I've done it already.
Okay, good.
I've done it already. Because, yeah, we were second in class, and it ended up being... Well, we were first in class, and then we got hit the first time. What was put us second, then that... I don't know where that will put us.
Fuck's sake. What a mess.
Just people not... Lack of care for other drivers who have had an incident.
Yeah, it's a tricky one because it's a beginner series. You know, there's a lot of people that don't know how to drive in this series. So, on the one hand, you have to account for that. On the other hand, you have to make sure that people learn from their mistakes. And this is the only way of doing it, really, to shove out penalties. But it doesn't help... You guys?
No, who get involved in it every race nearly now.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if they're doing the license system in this series. Be worth asking that question.
Yeah, I don't think they are.
I don't think they are because they think that they probably see it as too much of a beginner series.
Yeah, which is, I get it, but how are you going to learn if you're not told that is not how you do things? Ruining two people's races is
yeah
unacceptable.
I totally get your frustration. That's been me for the past like two seasons. It's just kind of slowly coming together now.
Is the stewarding done the same as in your series as F1 then? Or is it a bit more slack?
What's that, in real life?
Yes.
No, it's pretty strict, to be fair. There have been some hefty penalties this year. I mean, the racing, I think, to be fair, is a bit cleaner than F1. But no, they are fairly strict, to be fair, because it's overseen by the same stewards as Formula One. So,
okay. I thought there was maybe like a separate group, or it's only
we have our own like specific clerk of the course for our championship, but in the office, it's still overseen by the main F1 stewards. So any like track limit penalties or anything like that are given by the F1 stewards.
Okay. At least it's consistent then.
Yeah, I mean, there's always going to be, like, you know, the odd one that isn't how everyone would expect it to be in terms of penalties, but, you know, that's just racing, really.
Yeah, everyone's got different views on how things are.
Yeah, exactly. So,
because, I mean, it's when I'm helping steward in another season, and obviously you have like your own set rule book for each series. Everyone's different. Like, we have a different rule for blue flags, basically. It's a bit different to most, but it's only because it's online, so people are a hell of a lot more aggressive.
Yeah.
And they just end up taking you out. So but we always have them, well, they should just move out of the way. It's like, well, that's not the rule.
No.
If you do that, we will penalise you, simple as. But
People
still don't abide by it, and so you have to be really harsh on your penalties.
Yeah, the whole blue flag thing is always going to be tricky, especially like in this kind of series, because you've got the, like, say, people that are like literally beginners, like they've only just started, and when they see a car come up behind them, they literally just panic.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, and the only way of them learning is by racing again and again, but, you know, they need to be doing, like, you know, races offline and stuff to practice as well. But
yeah,
the best thing to do, like, with the blue flag is just stay on your line, because as soon as you move off your line, you're just unpredictable.
Oh, yeah, that's the worst, yeah. If you move suddenly and that's...
Yeah. But no, I think this season's been better than, like... It's definitely getting better than what it has been.
Yeah, I think the first season I watched of when Denise did it, I think... Maybe, like, the first two or three rounds were just... probably diabolical, really. but it's going to be for a first until we get everything settled in, everyone knows how they race against each other. But then if you bring new people in, but I think there's quite a good spread in this group at the moment.
Yeah, I think there is, actually.
You've got, obviously, like the aliens.
Yeah, you'll always have the aliens.
Doing their thing. And the silvers is pretty much guaranteed. But I think a bit lower down, I think there's still the... I don't know, because there's not really... You can't do too many groups. Like, there seems to be some pro women with very amateur women.
Yeah.
Or silverish women with very amateur women, and you can tell the difference with just how they drive and
The problem is, since the first, because it changed after the first, was it the first season or the second season? What I liked about the first season especially is everybody did qualifying laps, and then they paired people regardless of what teams they were from. They gave an inexperienced driver an experienced driver, and the idea was that they would coach them and help them to improve. Yep. That hasn't happened since that season.
Well, that should be... But the fact, I don't know if that's what they wanted from the series. I think that was more...
It's not, but it worked. in my opinion.
It did. It kept it kind of more level playing field because, you know, if you had a fast driver, like you say, paired up with one of the slower drivers, so it kind of balanced it out.
Yeah.
Whereas now you can have someone that's a fast coach teamed up with someone that's, you know, also a fast driver.
Yeah, and they just win every race.
Yeah.
It just gets a bit... But I suppose that's our racing. You're gonna get that. You're gonna get them people. But I think the classes wise just needs maybe a little tweak. But that's maybe for next season. I don't know.
It always needs tweaking. It needs tweaking during the middle of a season as well.
Yeah.
Mid race.
It's like, as much as I'm enjoying this season, I'm up against actual freaking aliens.
I know.
They're like 2 seconds faster a lap than me. I'm supposed to be in their class. That's what's silly about it.
I don't know. I can't remember who partnered them now. Car 102 with... does it tell you in the...
Is that Nat's car or is that Celine's car?
T Solberg.
Trolls, yeah, okay.
I don't know what pace he was doing, but it was ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, almost all of the other...
I know that's pro-am level, but that was just like... But the thing is, I'm not a pro. I'm really not.
I'm not a pro, Pixley.
But you're in silver.
Well, yeah, that's true. But silver's meant to be, like... I don't know what silver's meant to be. They're putting pros in silver, put it that way. Let's say that.
Oh, there's definitely pros in silver.
It's freaking aliens in silver. Yeah. Very much dislike it.
But that's the thing, though. You can't be that... You don't know who committed into the qualies or...
No, we didn't win, Pan. We came 10th.
That's the thing at the end of the day. Like, when you have a qualifying stage like that and, you know, people practice offline, as we all do, they know what lap times they can really achieve. But they don't have to do those lap times in the quali server, so they just back off and fit in where they want to fit in.
Yeah, that's the whole downside to it. But that's why I don't really like it as a one lap. It should be... either 5 consistent laps or 10 consistent laps. Yeah. That's the only way of doing it. But I think that'd be quite hard for a lot of these people. At the top pace, you'll have the aliens to be able to do it, but then the silvers, I think it'll vary a lot, and then obviously the arms, it'll be even harder. So then you'll see the difference.
Yeah.
Like I did, I can't remember what I did round Monza now, but I couldn't do that every lap. Jesus, I'd be pulling hair out and wheels and breaking pedals.
I would say that's the one thing that I'm really enjoying, as much as I also really hate it, is like actually being pushed to do lap after lap after lap ridiculously quick. Like, I think I got 2 really decent laps in during my stint. But being forced to do that with the pressure of like people watching, other pros trying to overtake you, trying to do well for the team and all of that stuff, I weirdly quite enjoy it more than I thought I would.
Stress things.
Yeah,
not wild.
Just stress things. But it's not like the stress that we had last season with the ST, where the stress was always about not spinning
car.
It. Yeah, exactly. Like, not actually spinning it every single fucking lap. At least this is good pressure.
Yeah.
You know, it's good. Speak
for yourself. stand the Ferrari. I don't know how people drive it.
It's not that bad.
I think the next one should be just the Lexus series, to be honest.
You would say that. They won't do that, unfortunately, because they can't do custom liveries with it.
They're not done.
They're going to have to set off for like the GTR then.
Yeah, I'd be happy with that.
Yeah, I'd be happy with that.
Yeah, I would be around Imola.
A million little piglet noises.
Just Imola, Imola, Imola.
Yeah.
Imola series. They haven't done GT4. What did they do for the first round? Was it whatever you chose?
The first season was GT4.
Because I was in the Aston.
I don't know why they don't go back to it. It's always been... I found it strange that they won't go back to GT4s. because it is the best, and especially like with new people coming into the sim.
Yeah, that's
and what learning how to drive. GT4s are the best for that because it's not easier, but it is easier, if that makes sense. There's a bit more margin for error. And
did everyone have to be in the same, or was it all mixed?
No, it was mixed. Mixed GT4s.
It was mixed.
Yeah.
So
I went for the Cayman, which is why I always like the Cayman now.
Yeah.
I like the Cayman.
It's awesome.
Oh, I did a Cayman series and I really didn't like it.
I did that series.
I'm starting to like it.
I really didn't like it.
Yeah. I loved it.
Maybe Cayman. It's because I was getting stressed because I was like, all I want to do is beat Denise. All I want to do is every time. And then I was like, and then I'd get to the back of you and then I'd just bin it.
I enjoyed that series. I kept beating you and I kept beating Charlie Bassett. I was like, well, happy.
To be fair, somehow me and Charlie Martin were like magnets to each other and I didn't quite enjoy it.
I don't think she enjoys sim racing at all. I get the impression it's not for her.
It's not quite her cup of tea.
Is there many people in the W series who do sim racing? Or is it just like a handful?
No, there's not many that actually do sim racing, to be fair. A lot of us did a lot of sim racing like through lockdown. But now, to be honest, I don't think any of them do. Maybe Bitesker, she might do actually, because she's got a crazy setup at home. But other than that, I don't think anyone else bothers.
We need to get Chadwick in the sim.
Oh my god, no. I just take her off.
Have a real fight.
Don't break into turn one, Sarah.
Oh no, it didn't work. Brake failure, week after week.
Oh my god, my brake pedal's not working.
Oh, what a shame. It's happening again.
I'm trying to get some of them to come do some sim racing, but some of them are still racing other things, so maybe through winter I might do some sim stuff, but I'm quite happy being on my own because it means none of them can beat me right now. So
yeah, nothing worse than try and get beaten on track and then maybe beaten on the step.
Yeah, I'm happy with that because, I mean, I just have to, like, punt them off or something accidentally. Put them wide.
It's always an accident with you, isn't it? It's weird, that.
I wouldn't do that, really. I enjoy a good close race, so I wouldn't do that. Not on purpose.
I don't think you do it by accident these days.
No.
You've ascended into the sim racing elite.
Yeah, woo!
It is a non-contact sport now.
I try so hard. Like, what was it? The second to last corner towards the end of that race run and very nearly went into the back and I was like, please stop.
You did well though. Like, you didn't hit her.
No, and I got close. So, yeah, I definitely stopped. Lost about four car lengths.
Yeah, but ultimately she binned it, which was
gonna
happen.
cracked under the pressure, you know.
That's why you sometimes that's all you need to do is just put pressure on people.
Yeah.
So I know why
I'm not quite as confident following someone else as I am someone following me. Because because I'm always too scared that they're gonna like brake check me or like brake slightly earlier than where I brake.
Yeah.
And then I just end up punting them. That's like I'm always a bit too scared of that, which is why I always brake a little bit earlier.
Yeah, but that's what you're meant to do anyway. So it's all
no.
You are if you're following someone.
No.
See, in real life racing, we don't brake until they brake.
Yeah, but oh, okay.
And that's my issue.
But I think in sim racing, you have like a. I think in sim racing, I don't know if it's true. I think there's a momentary like lag between seeing someone brake and then actually doing it yourself. Whereas in real life, you can react straight away, can't you?
Yeah. So can't quite get that into my head.
The one thing that concerned me about that one today is she went into the hairpin really early and I couldn't work out if that was the line she took, or if she was trying to block. It was quite strange.
I know. It's, to be fair, I have tried that line a few times, and like, it, you know, there's not really, it doesn't really make much difference. It's just because of the, there's like the camber of the track. If you dive in with the camber, it stops it a little bit faster. But
okay, I never knew that.
Yeah, yeah. I do it on the odd lap sometimes. Oh, that felt nice. And then the next lap, I'd slightly outbrake myself and miss the turning. I did definitely, I just enjoy racing at that track. It's a good track.
Yeah, it's, it is one of my favourites.
Yeah.
Just not, maybe not with this car. I'm undecided. It does, the weird thing is, it, when you're just doing laps, it feels really, really nice and it's good. When you're in a race situation, all of its little quirks and the bits that you don't get quite right seem to be amplified and you're just permanently pissed off with it.
Yeah. I found like when I was following, you got so much understeer. It was ridiculous.
Yeah.
But I don't know, it felt like a, I, you know, I thought the setup was all right. It was, wasn't doing anything too crazy.
Did you change the brake pads on it? Because that's one thing we noticed, what was wrong.
We went to pads one, didn't we? In the end.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, because that's what I noticed. Been like 10 minutes to go.
Okay.
Realised it's not breaking at all. Why? What's done with it? Then realised, yeah.
To be fair, all the practice I did was on brake pad two and I was faster.
I actually think I was potentially faster on two as well.
Yeah, it's, the thing is, though, it is very, I find it very different from, it's a different server.
Yeah, different, yeah.
Different temperatures, you've got the lag of other people, because that's one thing I'm struggling, I'm actually getting quite a bit of game lag now, for some reason. So when I'm going into, across the line, obviously you get like everything changes, I get a lag spike. And it can happen into the first corner and everything. So.
Oh my god.
But yeah, I think a new P is maybe the next thing, as it doesn't seem to want to operate now.
Yeah, that's like your worst nightmare. Like the second it freezes, you're like, oh my god. Just hope that there's no one around you.
Right then, guys, I'm going to leave it there. Thanks for today.
Yeah, I think I'm going to get some food.
Yeah, I'm going to hit the hay.
Nice. Well done. So, I know it's possibly not the result you wanted, but did well all the same.
Well, it's a podium on the in the class. It should be, yes. I think.
Nice.
At least it's not. At least it's finishing the race and not being at the back, which is a slight improvement considering where we qualified.
It's all good, and it's only race number three, so can only get better.
Exactly, we've got a long way to go yet.
Should be like,
and I've come a long way with Pixley. Pixley's helped me so much through this series. It's really improved my driving a lot.
Awesome.
I'm enjoying the racing now.
That's what it's all about.
Except when we get punted, that's the bit we don't like.
You know what the answer is, don't you? Just don't get punted.
Pump back. Yes. Oh.
It's easy.
No, don't.
Sorry.
Wow.
Next race, pump back. Right.
Okay, new team rule. Don't pump back.
That's fun.
You need to write that somewhere.
I really do.
Cool. All right, guys, I'm going to get some food. So
cool. Later. See you later, guys. Cheers.
See you later.
Bye. Bye.
And I'm going to end the stream there because I've got some work to do. Thank you for watching. What am I going to say next? My next race, I think, is on Thursday, which is a GT4 race at Alton Park with Pixley, who you've just been hearing from. So that should be fun. Thursday evening in the RCI GT4 Endurance Series. So yeah, hopefully see you then. Until then. Take care and enjoy the rest of your week. Bye.